18, 19, and 20. So we can count that 20 nucleotides upstream, AAG and G, would be actually our guide RNA sequence. And moreover, if you want to find PAM sequence in the first exon, so we can simply use Control F and we can write double G. So here you can see, here we have double G. We cannot take this because on the upstream there are only two nucleotides. Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will show you how we can design guide RNA for CRISPR genome editing. And as we know, CRISPR stands for clustered regularly interspaced short palindromic repeats. And CRISPR-Cas9 is actually a DNA editing technology. And Cas9 is actually an enzyme and it can make precise cuts in the DNA. And we also know that we can use this feature of Cas9 of cutting at precise location in the DNA for our own benefits. And it is also important to know that if it can cut at the precise location once it is reached to the target, but we should also know that who guides it to its target. And actually the thing which is guiding to the target, and once that target is achieved, so that Cas9 cuts that DNA part. So actually this is the guide RNA which guides the Cas9 to cut at specific location. So here you can see this guy is actually have specific location, and wherever it finds this target sequence, so it can cut the double-stranded DNA. So we can also use this feature for knockout and other genome editing purposes. So in order to know how actually CRISPR-Cas9 work for gene knockout in target genome, so here is one method which is used, that is called gene knockout by non-homologous end joining method, and which is also known as the hammer method. And as you know, if you can see, if this is a gene, here you can see this is actually one gene, and if it has one specific sequence, if we want to cut that specific part of exon, so first we need to identify that sequence. And here you can see we need to find a sequence. Here you can see the mention in the red color, this is the guide RNA sequence. So we need to find and we need to design one guide RNA sequence which is complementary to that target sequence. Here you can see the target sequence is mentioned in this color and the guide RNA sequence is mentioned in the red color. So whenever we need to knock out any sequence, we need to design one specific guide RNA sequence which is complementary to that target sequence. But we also need to make sure that this guide RNA sequence should be adjacent to this PAM sequence. And as we know that this PAM stands for protospacer associated motif. And here you can see in most of the cases, the PAM sequence, if we are reading 5' to 3', it is NGG. It means in this case, N can be anything like A, T, C, or G. It can be anything. But we must note that in the target sequence, wherever there is GG followed by anything, like it can be A, it can be T, it can be C or G. So we can identify that PAM sequence. And if we are taking it on the negative strand, and I mean if the sequence position is from 3' to 5', then of course we will do reverse complementation, and it would be G, C, and G with C, and N with N. So it can be anything with C, C, and again N can be A, T, C, or G. So let me show you a brief view how actually CRISPR-Cas9 works. So here is actually that guide RNA, and adjacent is the spacer sequence. And you can see whenever there is a Cas9, which is actually an enzyme or protein, so they form a complex. Here you can see they will form a complex, and that guide RNA sequence 5 to 3' here now Now it is now Cas9 and guide RNA complex, and once the target is achieved, you can see the Cas9 attaches to the actually the PAM sequence. Here that PAM sequence, and here is that target sequence, and here is actually our gene of interest. And if you can see, whenever it will find its target sequence adjacent to the PAM, so it will make a double strand cut through non-homologous end joining method. So if this is your actual gene in the wild type, here you can see it can also add. And as you know that when there is a double stranded break in the DNA, so in the next cycle, when the DNA automatically repair itself, so there would be an insertion, deletion, or the frame shift. And as we know that whenever there is insertion, deletion, or a frame shift in any protein, so we can use this feature to knock out any gene or any protein. Because if there would be insertion, deletion, or frame shift in any amino acid, so the overall structure of that protein is disturbed, and it will result in the dysregulation of that protein. And so we can check out whether what would be the effect of that single nucleotide polymorphism or indels in this protein, and what are its phenotype. So in this way, we can use this CRISPR-Cas9 for gene knockout in our target genome. So how we can manually find the guide RNA in a target sequence? So here is its first step. In this example here, you can see first step is to find PAM sequence. And as I have previously explained that NGG sequence is actually, here you can see this is GG, and if we consider it, this is the plus strand and this is the minus strand. And in the plus strand, here you can see this is GG and followed by T. So it means we can take any G as a PAM sequence, and now the upstream 20 or 19 nucleotides we can take as a guide RNA. So what in the step 2 here, you can see we can determine the 5 prime starts of the actual single guide RNA targeting sequence by counting 20 nucleotide upstream of the PAM sequence. Here you can see that was GG PAM sequence, and we can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, and 20. So we can count that 20 nucleotides upstream. So from this to this would be that here you can see, if we take this now, you can see this is the G, and next all this sequence double AC, you can see CGG, TGC, CTA, as such, you can see GAG, AAG, and G would be actually our guide RNA sequence. But make sure here, as here you can see in the PAM, in the final guide RNA sequence, there is no PAM sequence involved. Actually, the PAM sequence is important, but it is not finally included in the guide RNA sequence. So let me show you a few more example from databases. So I will show you one example that how we can design guide RNA from different databases. So here is one example. Here is that simple example which I have already just shown you in the PPT. In this example, I will show you how we can design guide RNA for this gene. That actually this gene belongs to rice. So let me take you to the rice database and show you that how we can design guide RNA for this gene. So we can go to this rice database. Here is ricedata.cn. So we can mention that ID. We can simply copy paste, and we can directly paste it here. So first of all, we need to retrieve its sequence. So we can simply click on this. There is a mistake. It should be LOS04. Yeah, I think so. Now it's right. So here you can see this is that gene. So here is rapid locus and here is MSU locus. So in actually the rapid locus, we can know what are the exons and introns positions. So let me open this one. So here you can see the RISE annotation project database. So in the blue color here, as you can see, this is actually the 5' sequence and this is the 3' sequence. And as we know that the 5' UTR and 3' UTR are important for expression, but not important in the protein. In the blue color here, you can see this is the first exon. This is the second exon. And similarly, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. And here is the overall gene structure. If you can see, if this gene is in this direction, I mean from left to right, this is the first exon, this is the second exon, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. And so if we want to knock out this gene in any plant, so we can actually choose any exon, because if we will choose introns, so quite possible, because introns are non-coding region, so quite possible that although introns are also important for expression, but quite possible because they are not finally become the part of protein, so we must choose any exonic region for designing of guide RNA. So most of the cases and in most of the studies, people choose only the first exon or the second exon. So let's suppose in this example we can choose this first exon. So we can simply copy the sequence of first exon. Here you can see. And moreover, if you want to find PAM sequence in the first exon, so we can simply use Control F and we can write double G. So here you can see, here we have double G. We cannot take this because on the upstream there are only two nucleotides, and here are actually the tetra G, so we cannot take. I think so it is good to take this G, double G, along with C as a PAM sequence. So we can consider this. I can little zoom in if you want. Yeah, here you can see. So in actually we can take this double G along with C as a PAM sequence, and we can take up 20 nucleotide upstream as a guide RNA sequence. So but as you know, these all things are very difficult when calculating through manually. So there are luckily, so we can check the specificity of any guide RNA through bioinformatics tools and some online web tools. So let me copy this one and we can check the specificity. We can check it through different online tools. So let me take you to one of the famous tool, that is ChopChop plant CRISPR tool. This is actually available for all species, even for humans, animals, and recently they have also updated for plants. So you can simply click on this ChopChop. Here you can see now we have ChopChop, and in this we can paste our target, and here we can choose our species, and here we can choose what we are using. We are using CRISPR-Cas9 or others, because in this example we are using for CRISPR-Cas9, and our purpose is knockout. So we can simply paste our target here. We can also mention different gene ID, but if you want to paste the sequence, so you can simply paste your sequence here. So let me copy from this one. Yeah, this is the first exon. So we want to design our guide RNA from this first exon. So we can simply copy this one. We can take to ChopChop and paste our first guide RNA to design our first guide RNA here. And from here we can select and search our species. So our species is actually Oryza sativa. So because here we will use the Kitaki version, because this is actually a cultivar which is sequenced. So and we will simply click on this find target site. So you can see your job has been successfully submitted. So your rank in the Q is actually 2, so we have to wait a little for this. So as here you can see, now we have different target sequences and different guide RNA sequence and their GC content and their position, whether it is plus strand or negative strand, their self complementarity, and if they, how many sequences are found in the database, if there are 0 mismatch, if there are 1 mismatch, 2 mismatch and 3 mismatch. So it is good if these two values like mismatch 1 and 2 and 3 all are 0, but it is also fine if both of mismatch 1 and mismatch 2 are 0, but mismatch 3 have 1 or 2, so it is totally fine. So if you can see, this is actually that sequence we have pasted. As here you can see, I will mouse over any guide RNA sequence. So you can see they will mention their rank, so that we can choose any green one. And here you can see if we, I can select, so it is mentioning the number 4. So if we come to this number 4, here you can see its GC content is 70%. So as we know that GC content should be around 30 to 80% or 75%. And here you can see the mismatches at 1, 2, 3 is actually the all are 0, so it would be good. So it means we can take any of this guide RNA sequence and we can directly send this sequence to design oligos to any biotechnological company. So they will send you the primer so you can start building your vector for CRISPR-Cas9. And let me take back you to few more considerations. It is also important to avoid off targets, and we have also further consideration. So here are the successful examples of few guide RNAs. So as here you can see, the most of the effective guide RNA sequence starts from G. So what next is actually, if this is the first, I mean, if it should start from the first sequence, should be the guanine, I mean, that should be the G, then the 17th sequence should be ART. Why we should have on the first G and the 17th? At the 17th we should have A. So I will explain this thing into later on other videos. And there are also few more, that GC content should be between 40 to 80%, and similarly the length of guide RNA should be 17 to 24 base pair. And similarly, it is also important to look for off target effects in that guide RNA sequence. And here are few testing efficiency and specificity of candidate guide RNA through online tools. So here are the list of few online tools. So one of the famous one is ChopChop, which is designed by Harvard, and Cas Op Finder, similarly CRISPR Optimal Target Finder, and eCRISP and SnapGene. And here are few for plants. Here you can see the CRISP P2.0, and similarly CRISPR GE, CRISPR Direct, CRISPR Plant, and ChopChop Plant. So which I have already demonstrated in the example. So hopefully now you can design your guide RNA to knock out any target sequence by yourself. So if you have still any question in designing the guide RNA for your gene, please let me know in the comments section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.